like to introduce Senator Liz Krueger and ask her to bring us a greeting as well.
Thank you. I'm delighted. It's silly to say you're delighted when you're talking about domestic violence, but look at all the talent we have around here. We have the experts from the field, both in providing services to victims of domestic violence and from the criminal justice system. We have our colleagues from the Assembly, who in fact have been moving One House bills to help victims of domestic violence, to support the kinds of laws we need in New York State. And now they have partners in us in the Senate Democrats who are committed to dealing with these very, very painful issues. Just a little policy. One quarter of high school girls have been the victims of physical abuse, sexual abuse, or date rape. Approximately 15.5 million children are exposed to domestic violence every year nationally. We have major issues with confidentiality and protecting people who not only have escaped domestic violence, but who then still have to fear for their lives and their children's lives and may not, under New York State's law, be comfortable cooperating with the criminal justice system, which then, of course, just increases their future risks and those of others. We have a direct relationship in New York State between the problems of inadequate housing and shelter assistance and people being trapped remaining in situations of domestic violence. They can't leave their abusers because they can't deal with ending up homeless. What kind of choice is that in New York State for families and children to have to make a decision between continuing to put their lives at risk or fearing that they end up on the streets of our state with no options? We have to deal with the relationship between domestic violence and immigration laws. We passed a terrific human trafficking law last year in this state, but we have to continue the assignment to make sure that whether or not you have legal status in this country, we are not allowing you to end up being abused sexually, emotionally, and physically because your abuser takes control of your life because of your fears about your legal status in this country. There are endless states that have moved farther than New York. And so our goal as a task force is to make sure that when we revisit these questions a year from now, 2 years from now, we're no longer saying 19 other states have better penalties for children who have been the witness of domestic violence.